basically female entrepreneurs, entrepreneurship, and womanhood in general, with a beautiful looking woman, a looker, a dreamer, a doer, Shilpa Shetty. She is a living example right in front of our eyes. Shilpa, 24 years. Tell me your defense mechanism, the way you deal with things. How have you sustained, survived, grown and excelled at being the brand Shilpa Shetty that you are?
Is it still morning?
Yes.
Very good afternoon to everyone present. I'm actually in August company. Girl power. This
yes.
is us.
Yes.
You know, I don't know if I really could contrive it. I never did. I just lived life. The only one thing that I have done constantly and consistently is never stopped learning. I still feel like I'm a student. It's people like you that remind me, and I've been reminded over the last 3 days constantly that it's been 24 years because Bazigar completed 24 years 3 days ago. But I never even thought that it's been such a long journey. I'm still trying to relearn and redo the things that I think I know because I think I can do them better. So I think that's what's kept me going. Answering your second question, brand Shilpa. I take that as a huge compliment. I, again, never thought that I set out to becoming this brand that has some kind of weight. I'm an actor first, but today people see me as a catalyst in the field of health and wellness. And I prefer to be known as that more than for my acting abilities that I'm trying to, you know. I've got selective amnesia. But I'm very proud that you know I come from that milieu and that is my first identity. But I really believe that it's never too late to kind of change lanes and realize what your calling is. And I think I learned pretty late, but I believe that it's better late than never. That my passion lies in spreading knowledge about health. Not that I'm a know-it-all, but out of my own experiences, out of the meetings that I've had with various people that have come up to me, and more of them kind of complimenting me on the way I have, you know, maneuvered my life or my body or, you know, what my, Sadhviji and I were having this whole conversation that, you know, people think that you're happy and they want to kind of emulate you because you're so glamorous, but they don't know that what makes you the person you are and what makes you appealing is the joy that you get from the peace that you have within. And that truly is the truth, and it couldn't have been better put because she knows me. I've had the opportunity to spend some time with her. So, whilst I look very glamorous, I don't think, I'm sure there are a lot of people out there who are very successful and well-to-do and, you know, they have it all going for them. But sometimes there's something missing. And I just think that what a lot of people have missing in the midst of everything that they have is a bit of alignment. And I just feel like it's become my duty to kind of tell people how easy it is to align yourself. Because once you're aligned with your mind, body, soul, life becomes so much more easier. I mean, it's perfectly normal to break down sometimes, you know, this fast-paced, goal-oriented mindset that we all have now. It's perfectly normal to kind of step back and think, you know, where am I, what am I doing?
So answering another part of that question, how do you keep it going?
Mm.
I think that comes from the thought process of what are my I ams? What are the I ams that come out of my mouth? You know, we have to sit and get a little introspective when we say, you know, I'm tired, I am fed up, I'm so lonely, I'm so sad, you know, I'm so hardworking, but I'm not getting success. My I ams are very different. I am strong, I am powerful, I am someone who is a survivor, I am proud, I am a woman. Those are my I ams, and that is consistent. And I am a believer. So I think whatever be the situations, I've been through many ups and many lows. The one thing that will be in my inner monologue and on my mouth, in my heart, will be the same. And I think that comes through yoga. My I ams are very positive.
Nice.
So yeah, so that's how I've survived it.
I really believe that beauty is only skin deep, really. And I really mean that because I, for one, without being modest, I don't think I'm the conventional good looker. And I have never been. I've burnt a lot of my adolescent pictures. So I was this thin, rocky, dark girl. Some of those pictures had also made it on the internet and they went viral, and people thought that, you know, I've changed my color. And I just want to set the record straight. I used to be a state level volleyball player, so I spent like nearly five or six hours in the sun every day. So I turned like some 12 shades darker. But saying that, I really think that the world over, people don't just go for looks, they definitely go for matter. And that's what matters most.
Okay. And let's talk about yoga. Yoga has been a very important thing in your personal life. It's transformed you as a person. And you have used yoga that arouses a lot of curiosity about India world over to your advantage as well. How has your association been with yoga over the past so many years that has given you also a different kind of image?
I think I've used yoga to the fullest. And yes, you're right, I've had many benefits with yoga, mentally, physically, I think soulfully. And I just wanted to make sure that if people ask me how I do it, this is the route to take. And there is no other way to do it. So yeah, I have taken that route. And like you very rightly said, the world over, has kind of adapted to yoga and looks up to yoga. But I just feel like, I think 10 years ago when I did my first DVD, there wasn't that much appreciation for yoga. I mean, we come from a country from where yoga hails from, but we don't have that kind of respect
for it. We suddenly have respect for it when Madonna does it.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, with due respect. So I just felt, and also there was this thing about yoga is for old people. So I was like, I really wanted to debunk, you know, those preconceived notions, and it's made a huge difference to my life. I think it brings about a certain stillness and this constant motion.
you can.
Why wouldn't I want to propagate it?
Yeah. And talking about the four S that don't go wrong as a business proposition, food, film, fitness, fashion, you have had your hands deep into all four of them for a really, really long time. Do you think so?
I think we somewhere in there we dabble with these four F's. Yes, I have got my hands dirty. Belonging to this milieu, but you learn. You learn from experiences, and I just think that with experiences it gives you a bit of maturity, and you can't buy experience. So what I used to look like 24 years ago. And my confidence with those experiences has changed the kind. This is the age of social media where all these things really matter.
Yeah, and talking about social media, she is so active. She's one of those very few women who saw power of social media much early in life. And she was one of those persons who had her own YouTube channel, her own website, way earlier than your other contemporaries had. You were a far-sighted person. Are you in touch with the future trends and where the technology is going and where the world is going?
I don't know about that. I just think that I've always wanted to be a trendsetter in life, whether it be, you know, style or whatever I want to be remembered as. I just think that it's just simple maths that in a country of a billion people, we have, I think the statistics say that we have around maybe 167 TVs, but then we have some 650 SIM card users, and then we have another 400 odd internet users. So why not the digital way? I mean, it's just not rocket science. And I mean, taking it from there, I also, you know, I started cooking on YouTube because I wanted, you know, I really feel like I'm an old soul in a new body, which we all are, which we don't kind of resign to. But I am this very old soul in this so-called young body, I want to call myself. But I want, you know, I feel like this generation is steering towards aping the West. There's nothing wrong with the West. I think there's a lot that we can take from them. They're very driven, they're very focused. You can't go meet them without an appointment. I think we should do those things. But when it comes to being culturally bound, spiritually anchored, going back to doing things from scratch, something as simple as cooking. I don't know why we order, my manager will scream at me if I take the name of an aerated drink, so I'll just say aerated drink. So we order an aerated drink, or we, you know, we treat our children with junk food, making it aspirational, making it seem like, oh, it's a great thing. You are being rewarded for something with junk food. So your child is being inculcated with these bad eating values. When homestyle cooking and Indian cooking is the most healthy for your systems, I don't know why we emphasize so much on values and, you know, touching our parents' feet, and we make sure that our children, you know, does a namaste when an elder enters the house. How is that, you know, we don't pay so much importance or emphasis on eating habits? So I have a huge problem with that. And then I feel this generation is so busy working, me too, that we feel that Indian cooking is very cumbersome. So resort to ready-made foods. We're not reading the back, you know, we're not reading at the back of the packs. Label reading is so important. While we're all so educated, make use of that education. You know, they've written that, you know, it's got bad sugars, but you will still buy it. And it's so easy to cook quick, healthy meals. So I wanted to show people that if I can do it, and if I can cook a meal for my child and my family in 5 minutes, you can too. So my entire tryst with cooking happened because I also enjoy cooking. I just felt that maybe if I could play a catalyst in changing the mindset of the younger generation, and, you know, people maybe are also scared to go into the kitchen and say that, oh, okay, I don't know how to cook. I'm not saying that, you know, I'm Nigella Lawson. I'm just saying that if I can cook, so can you. And I wanted people to be encouraged to get into the kitchen and dabble with Indian food and our spices and ghee and coconut oil and all the great stuff that we have.